technology as being human, and then vice versa on a subconscious level, then therefore human beings are nothing more than technology. And what's really deep about this is that robots and machines, computers, they're all programmable. You can program them to do anything what you want. But if you perceive human beings as the same thing, then therefore human beings can be programmed to do whatever you want. So when we talk about eugenics, what we're really talking about is a power structure that can ultimately program people's mind, which is really what television does, program people's mind to do exactly what is told to them as slaves. And so television does that, but now it's getting to the point where the physical incursion of technology is going to be used. Brain chips, RFID chips, all of these things that are being cybernetic technologies that's being pushed in the forefront. You guys even look at what's in the entertainment industry, a lot of what we're seeing is robotic references, robotic sounds, digitized sounds, the interaction. Matter of fact, let me just say this. One of the major programming songs over the last decade that people really need to take a look at with a critical eye is a song by Beyonce called Put a Ring on It. Most people think that she's talking about, if you're a man, put a ring on her finger to keep her. Wait a minute. If you're a woman, you shouldn't be dressed like that and be all raunchy like that in the first place, and let alone telling someone whether or not they should be putting a ring on your finger. But what's deep about it is that she's not talking about, you know, she's not talking about put a ring on a human finger. If you look at it, her hand is a robot arm. So what is she saying? I'm talking about symbolically on a subliminal level. What is she really telling to these young girls? What is she really telling to these young girls imprinting into their subconscious? Put a ring on technology through marriage, of technology in the human body. You can be happy. You see what
very,
I mean?
Very, very deep. Yeah, you know, another really thing that popped into my mind, would this be a part of what your belief system is, that when you can look at a human being and you can see them as a programmable, non-human entity, something that's just technology, so then the compassion and then the fellow feeling goes out the window, that you can just do whatever you want with this?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, precisely.
Oh, my goodness. That's quite frightening there.
And see, that justifies eugenics.
Okay.
You're not a human being. You're just a robot. So, you know, I can tell you that you don't have the right to reproduce or to create life or to do this or to do that. That's the psychology of it.
That's one notch worse than slavery, where, you know, Africans were looked at as subhuman, so we can do whatever we want.
See, and humanity really has to think about this, because we can talk about, you know, enslavement of African people and the trial and tribulation of that, but wait a minute, what's really taking place now is the enslavement of the human species. We're talking about
the
stakes have been raised.
Universal mind control. The artist's name is Common Sense. This is in the hip-hop genre. And Pharrell, both very big artists. And if you look at the video, you will see Pharrell dressed in a robot head. Now, part of what you've been discussing, and part of what anyone who's involved in this business already knows, because we do get our information from certain sources, there is a blending, actually, there's a dehumanization of humans, and there is a humanization of machines.
Yeah, that's
even
right.
When you look at the Transformers, the movie when it came out, people don't even see the fact that you have this robot talking to you, expressing feelings, having emotions, and people just sit there like, oh, this is so nice. This is so, look at the special effects, and don't even realize they're being predictably programmed. It's such a simple thing. And now within the music, you have an individual, and I'm saying names here because I know what it is, and I have no problem in saying this stuff. There's a gentleman there by the name of T-Pain. He uses a voice box called Auto-Tune, and it takes his voice and it moves it to give it some sort of synthesized sound, which actually takes a human voice and makes it sound more robotic.
Yeah.
Where on the other side, as I said, in the movies, you can see the robots are becoming more humanized.
Mm-hmm.
And in the process of this happening, it's a dialectic that is going to end up in a synthesis.